Hello students, welcome to my 16th lecture of accountancy. We have discussed the format of investing activities. Today we have completed three sums related to do that, right? Today we'll do another sums related to investing activities. Page number 286, question number 18. Investing activities. Draw a format of 10 to 12 lines. Particular amount and amount. Right? So, in the question they have given, from the following given information, calculate cash flow from investing activities. First, they have given sale of non-current investment. By selling our investment, we have earned money. That's why cash comes in. That's why we'll add this amount. Then comes purchase of land. By purchasing the land, we are giving the cash. That means that is our cash outflow. Right? So, we'll deduct that amount. Then comes purchase of machine. Purchase of machine, that is our expense. That means we have to pay money on behalf of that. That's why we have to decrease it, because that is cash outflow. Then comes sale of furniture. By selling our furniture, we earn cash. Right? Then comes dividend received on investment. On investment, we earn the dividend. That's why we have to add this in this activity, right? In operating activities, we are minus. We are deducting that. Why? Because that was our non-operating income. But here, this is our investing income. Then comes paid for goodwill. That means we have purchased something and we paid money for goodwill. That is not written off. We have paid the amount for goodwill, and goodwill is our intangible assets, right? If they have used the word written off goodwill, then it will come under the head operating activities. But here they give paid for goodwill. That means that is our investing activities. Then comes issue of share. Issue of share is our financial activity. So we'll not add it here. Then comes redemption of debenture. That means we repaid the amount of debentures to debenture holders. Debenture holders means the person from whom we take the money or borrow the money, right? So they are our lenders and we have to return their money back to them. That's why redemption of debenture is not included in investing activity. That will be included in financing activity, so will not give any effect related to that. Then comes loan borrowed. Loan borrowed is also financing activities, right? That's why we'll not write it here. So we'll write step by step. First comes sale of non-current investment. That will add sale of non-current investment amount 88,000. Then second, purchase of land. By purchasing the land, our cash goes out. Purchase of land, that means cash outflow, so we have to deduct it from 88,000. So 1,48,000 we have to deduct. That's why we'll write this amount in bracket. Then comes purchase of machine. Purchase of machine. 98,000. By purchasing a machine, we give the cash on behalf of machine, that's why we have to deduct this. Then comes sale of furnitures. By selling our furniture, we earn some money, right? Sale of furniture. That's why we have to add this amount, and the amount is 45,000. Then, next, dividend received on investment. Dividend received on investment. That means this is our investing activity, so we have to add, because this is our income. Dividend received on investment. Amount is 40,000. Then next, that is paid for goodwill. That means we have purchased goodwill, and on behalf of goodwill we are paying some money back to them, right? So we have to minus this amount from here, paid for goodwill, as goodwill is our intangible assets, right? If they have used the word written off, then this amount will write in operating activities, not in investing activities. But they give paid for goodwill. If they have used the word paid, then that is investing activities. And if they use the word written off, then that is our operating activities. Amount is 32,000. We paid for goodwill, that means cash outflow. Cash goes out, right? Then comes issue of shares. Shares is our financing activities, right? So we'll not write amount of issue of share in this investing activity. Then comes redemption of debenture, as we have discussed, that this is also our financing activities. That's why we'll not add this amount in investing activity. Then comes loan borrow. Loan borrow is also our financing activities. So we'll write it in financing activities, not in investing activities. Now we'll do the total, and the total will be minus 1,05,000, right? This answer is known as cash flow. Cash flow from investing activities. Right? Here the sum is completed. Write it down in your file book. Completed? Complete? Next one, page 287, question 19. From the given details, calculate cash flow from investing activity. See, we did question 18. In that, they have given the information of 1 year only, right? But in this sum, they have given information of 2 years. That means 31,316 and 31,317. That means one amount is opening balance and another amount is closing balance, right? So if they give two amounts, then we have to prepare accounts. If they give one amount, then no need to prepare accounts. So first comes plant and machines. See, is the difference in both the amount? That means opening amount and closing amount both are different. Yes, in the opening balance of plant and machine is 7,20,000 and closing balance is 9,20,000. So during the year they have purchased a machine, that's why the amount of machine is increased, right? So we have to give effect of this difference amount as we have done sums related to this type, right? Illustration 11, 12 and 13. So we have to prepare account of plant and machine. Then comes depreciation fund on plant and machine. Depreciation fund will prepare the account of depreciation fund, right? Why? Because there is difference in that amount. But depreciation, that is our non-cash expense. And non-cash expense is we are adding in operating activities. So will not give any effect related to depreciation fund. Will only prepare the account of depreciation fund, right? That means we have to prepare two accounts till now. First one is plant and machinery and second one is depreciation fund, right? Then comes goodwill. In goodwill, there is also difference, right? 95,000 and second one is 90,000. That means closing amount is 90,000. That means decrease in that amount, that means we have written off that goodwill, right? Then comes, so we have to prepare account of goodwill, but written off goodwill, that will come under the head operating activity. So will only prepare the account, will not give any effect of that in statement. Then comes patent. Opening balance of patent is 1,30,000 and closing balance of patent is 70,000. That means during the year we sold that patent, right? So we earn the money. So that difference amount will write in statement. So we'll prepare account of patent too. So till now we have to prepare four accounts. First one, plant and machines. Second one, depreciation fund. Third one, goodwill, and fourth one, patent, right? And in this four account will give only two effects, that is of plant and machines and patent in statement. Other two accounts will prepare only to find the difference, but will not write any difference amount in the statement. Then comes 10% investment. And is there difference in that amount? Yes. In the beginning of the year, the amount was 2,70,000 and at the end of the year, the amount is 95,000. So during the year, we sold some investments. By selling that investment, we earn the money. That means this is our investing activity. So we'll write the difference of this account in the statement. So this is our fifth account which we have to prepare. Then comes general reserve. So general reserve is our provision, so no need to prepare that account, right? Then comes profit and loss account, that is also a provision and this effect will be given in operating activities. That's why we'll not prepare account of that. Then comes bank loan. Bank loan is financing activity, so here will also not give any effect related to bank loan account. Then comes current liabilities. Next one, current liabilities. Current liability is our operating activity, so we'll not write it here. Then comes interest received on investment. That is our investing activity, so we'll write it here. And in the last, they said that some of the patents were sold during the year. That means, as we discussed, that patent is our intangible assets. And if we sold our intangible assets, then we'll earn the money. That's why we have to add the amount of patent. Okay? So here we have to prepare five accounts. First one, plant and machinery. Second one, depreciation fund. Third, goodwill. Fourth, patent. And fifth, investment, right? So we'll prepare all five accounts of 4 to 5 lines. Okay, draw all the accounts. Credit, rupees, particular, rupees, particular, debit, rupees, credit, particular, rupees, particular, debit. Then next, goodwill. Credit, rupees, particular, rupees, particular, debit, right? There is no space, that's why I am first preparing three accounts, then we'll prepare two, okay? See, first, that is plant and machinery. You know the reason why we have to prepare plant and machinery. I'm discussing this again, right? Plant and machinery is activity related to investing, right? So we have to prepare this account, as well as they have given two amount, opening and closing, and there is difference between both the amount, right? That's why we have to prepare this account. Plant and machine, all the assets have debit balance, so we'll write here to balance brought down and balance carry forward. That means closing balance will come here, my balance carry forward. Opening amount is 7,20,000 and closing amount is 9,20,000, right? Then no other additional information in this question. That means the total of this account is 9,20,000, and on debit side also this must be 9,20,000. So the difference will be 2 lakh, and this 2 lakh will write as to bank account. Why? Because during the year we purchase the plant and machine worth rupees 2 lakh, right? So we'll write only this difference amount in the statement. Now we'll prepare second, that is depreciation account. As I told you that no need to give any effect in depreciation fund in statement. Why? Because depreciation fund is our non-cash expense, and this expense will write in operating activities, right? So the balance of depreciation fund is 1,20,000. Fund has credit balance, by balance brought down, amount is 1,20,000. And closing amount to balance carry forward, that is 1,50,000. Total is 1,50,000. Why? Because they have not given any additional information related to depreciation fund. 1,50,000. Difference is 30,000. That means during the year the additional depreciation is 30,000. This we have created from our profit, right? So here we'll write by P&L account. See, this is the effect of P&L, and P&L related effects are not given in investing activities, right? This will be given in operating activities. So will show only the account, will not give the difference amount in the statement. Then comes goodwill. Opening balance 95,000, closing balance 90,000, right? Goodwill is our intangible asset, so it has debit balance to balance drawn down. And the amount is 95,000. And closing amount by balance carry forward, that is 90,000. Right? See, if they have not given any information relating to selling in patent, in the last they have given the information that some of the patent were sold during the year. If they have not given that, then we'll take this difference amount as written off, right? And in goodwill, they have not given any information relating to selling. That's why the difference amount will take as written off amount, right? And that written off amount is turned through P&L, right? So here we'll write, first of all we'll write the total, that is 95,000, and the difference amount is 5,000 by written off goodwill, right? Total is 95,000. So will also not give any effect of written off amount. Why? Because written off amount is considered in operating activities. Okay, so from this three account will give only effect of plant and machinery, not of this two, right? Prepare, write it down. Completed. Still two accounts are remaining, so now we'll prepare those two accounts. Next account, that is patent account. Patent account is of 4 to 5 lines. Then next one is 10% investment account. Debit, particular amount or rupees, particular amount and credit. See, patent. Patent is our intangible assets, and assets have debit balance, right? So the debit balance is, that means opening. Opening balance is 1,30,000. To balance brought down 1,30,000. Then closing balance is 70,000 by balance carry forward, that is 70,000. no other information related to that. They have only given that during the year some of the patents were sold. That means the difference amount is not written off amount. If they have not given this information, then we'll write difference as written off. But they have given information that during the year we sold the patent. So we'll write this amount as by bank account. Why? Because we sold this patent. Total is 1,30,000 on both the side. And the difference will be 60,000. Right? We sold the pattern. That's why we earned the money. So this amount will add in investing activities. Then second, 10% investment account. Opening balance is 2,70,000. Investment is also our asset. So opening amount will write on debit side as to balance brought down. And the amount is 2,70,000. Closing amount will write on opposite side, that means credit side, as by balance carry forward. And the carry forward amount is 95,000. See, investment is never written off. So that means the difference will come on credit side. The total of both the side will be 2,70,000. 2,70,000. Right, and the difference will be 1,75,000. It comes on credit side. That means during the year we sold our investment. So we'll write this amount as by bank account, because we earn the cash on behalf of investment, sell or sold, whichever word you like to write. Okay, so complete this two account. Now then will prepare statement. Okay, write it down. Completed. After 10% of investment, the next one was general reserve and P&L. This both are our provision, right? The difference amount is our provision. That's why we have not prepared account of general reserve and P&L. Then equity share capital and bank loan. This both are our financing activities, right? That's why we have not prepared those account here, because will prepare those account in financing activity. Here will ignore this two things. Then current liabilities. In current liability, that is our operating activities, and in that we are only finding increase and decrease amount, right? So no need to prepare that account too. Then comes interest received on investment, that will direct give effect in statement. So now we'll prepare the statement of cash flow from investing activities. Prepare this statement of 6 to 7 lines. particular amount and amount. First was plant and machine. We have prepared the account of plant and machine, and by preparing that account we got to know that we purchased plant and machine during the year worth rupees 2 lakh. So here we'll deduct this amount. So first of all we'll write purchase of plant and machine worth rupees 2 lakh. We purchase the machine, that means cash goes out. So we'll write 2 lakh into bracket. That means this amount is negative. Then comes depreciation fund. As I told you that that amount is written off from P&L and that is our operating activities. That's why will not give any effect in this statement. Then we have prepared goodwill. Goodwill is also written off, right, during the year, and the difference amount is 5000. This written off amount will also write in our operating activities as non-cash expense, right? So will not write this amount in this statement. Then we have prepared patent. In this patent they have given information that during the year some of the patent is sold, right? That's why we'll have to give the effects of patent. If they have not given that information, then the difference will be considered as written off amount, right? So here we'll write sale of patent. By selling the patent, we earn the money. That means that is our cash inflow, and that difference is 60,000. Right? Then next, we have prepared 10% investment account, right? And in that difference comes on credit side. That means we sold that investment, and by selling the investment, we earn the cash. That means that is our cash inflow. So we have to write sell off 10% investment $1,75,000. Right? We sold the investment, that's why we have to add this amount. Then comes general reserve, P&L, equity share, bank loan, current liability. No need to give effect of them, right? As we have discussed earlier about them. So I'm not repeating this point here. Then last one is interest received on investment. That is our investing activity, right? So we have to add interest received on investment. Amount is 18,000. We have completed with all the information, and the difference is 53,000. So here we'll write the cash flow from investing activities. Okay, write it down. Complete. With this sum, we have completed all the sums of investing activities, right? Next step is last activity, and that is financing activities, right? So first of all, we'll prepare the format of financing activities. Statement of cash flow from financing activities. Particular amount financing. See, we'll discuss everything later. First of all, I am writing the format only. Okay. First comes issue of shares and debentures. See, company is issuing shares and debentures. By issue of the shares, company is earning the money on behalf of their shares and debentures. So cash comes in the business, that's why this amount is adding in this statement. Then comes proceeds from long-term borrowings. Long-term borrowings means bank loan or any other loan we have taken from others, right? So this borrowings, by borrowing we earn the cash, right? We get the cash right now, so we have to add this amount in financing activities. Then comes short-term borrowings. In that, 2 points, first and second. Short term borrowings was first increase in bank overdraft and cash credit. See, by increasing we get the money, that's why we have to add this amount. And second one in this short term borrowings is decrease in bank overdraft and cash credit. So we have to deduct this amount, so we'll write amount of this in bracket, right? So 2 points are there in borrowings. See, we have done one sum in operating activities where we have not give any effects of bank overdraft, right? Because that was our financing activities. Then comes payment of final dividend. Dividend is paid on shares. So if company is purchasing shares, on behalf of that company is giving some interest, but the interest given on shares is known as dividend. On shares, the extra amount which we give, that is known as dividend, right? So we have to pay the dividend to the shareholders. So this amount we have to deduct, because by paying the dividend our cash will be decrease. Then comes payment of interim dividend. Payment of interim dividend. Interim dividend means interest, that means dividend. Dividend we have to pay in at the end of the year. And if the company wants to pay this dividend amount in the mid of the year, that means in between the year, right? So that is known as interim dividend. Company is paying this dividend, that's why we have to deduct this amount too. Then comes repayment of loan. If we have taken the loan from anyone, then we'll pay repayment of loan. That means we are giving money back to them. So by returning those loan, our cash will decrease, so we have to deduct this, right? Write it down. Completed. After repayment of loan, next one is redemption of debentures and preferential. That we have to deduct. Why? When we issue the debenture, we earn the money. But when we redeem the debenture, that means we are giving their money back to debenture holders. That's why our cash will decrease. So that is our cash outflow, and cash outflow is subtracted from all the activities, right? Then comes interest paid on debentures and loan. Interest paid on debentures and loan. Debentures and loan means our borrowing money. When we borrow money from anyone else, we have to return their money back to them, right? And on those amount, we have to pay certain amount as interest, right? So that interest is our expense. By giving this, that interest, our cash will decrease, right? So we have to subtract this amount. Then comes, everything has been completed, right? So here, the statement is completed, and this total of this statement is known as cash flow from financing activities. If the answer comes in positive, then that is our cash inflow, and if answer comes in negative, that means in bracket, then that is our cash outflow. Your homework. Next thing is your homework. Your homework is you have to do this format for 3 times in your rough book. Okay. Say I am repeating your homework. Your homework is you have to do this format for 3 times in your rough book. Okay. We'll meet in our next video lecture. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take care.